So doing another install and pulling a lot of cable for the stage area, and I'm just gonna quickly show you what the install actually looks like. So we start out with there's going to be a rack over there. It's going to be the S32 stage box. So in another video I showed you the run that was going from that's going to be from there. It goes up along the top of this facade here. So you have to go through that beam, go through here, go into this facade, and then it goes back there. I'll show you that in a minute. And then there's going to be six XLRs there that's going to be terminated into a faceplate. And then there's going to be another four there by the percussion. And then there's going to be another four over here where the keys are. And one is going to be for a return, and then there will be three mic inputs or line inputs. Also, we're putting in a PA, so we're putting in a speaker on that beam, and we're also putting another speaker on that beam right there. So basically what I have to do is I have to go from the rack, up the facade, back out, and then back in there, there's like a little cove that's for ventilation. So I'm going to go into the ventilation cove and then out through here. Now, it's not really a plenum. It's just a big area with a fan, and it's just exhausting outside. So there's no worry there. Anyway, so part of the reason why I'm making this video is just another bad electrician, unfortunately. So, I mean, you'd look at this video and you'd say, oh, well, I'm a bad installer because I got all this wire laying around. I'm not done yet. I just wanted to show you this before it got too late in the day. And what I wanted to show is just a couple different things that are just kind of disappointing. And you know, this is, you know, it does look like this electrician has been doing it for a while. He's kind of older. He's probably in his 50s. So here's the hole that I made, and I'm going to put in my box soon enough. Now, I've taken this off just so you could see this. Every plate has this. So the first thing you see right here is this hole right here and this marker right there. Now, you probably say, oh, you know, well, that's not horrible. Well, it kind of is when you have a client like this. This client is very picky about the facade on this installation. So you could see what the guy was trying to do. He was trying to cut out for this this old work or new work, whatever, box. And you can see that what's happening is he's trying to cut this out here just to make room for these side pieces. Now, in doing so, either being over eager or whatever, if you look in here, this is the neutral side of the box, and then this is the hot side of the box right here. Now, you can see the spacing in there is probably no bigger than this screw right here. So what's been happening is, and I'll show you this in a second, is so he made this bigger to this cutout here just to get this in here, but he, being overzealous, he's overcranked the screw on it. So what's happened is it's actually the way that thing has the little feet that stick out that grab into the back of the wall. Because he's over tightened it, he's actually had it so the edges of the box have actually crushed in. So now they're really, really close to the screws here. And, you know, over time with wood expanding and contracting and all that other stuff, you know, it is potential that that gap is just so tiny that, you know, it could short out on there. Now, what he's done to mitigate this is on this side and only this side, he's actually put a piece of tape on it. He hasn't put it on the neutral side, probably because he knows that the neutral is bonded to earth here if he's done it right. So that's the first thing that's kind of scary to me is that he's tightened this box. I think he could have used a different type of box than this. that didn't have these little side pieces. Of course, I don't put in these type of boxes myself, so I don't know. The other thing is that the way that he actually cut all these holes, it looks like he just took a drill and drilled it, and then on the side here, and then he had one of those oscillating tools, and he cut in, but he used a starter hole. Well, with those oscillating tools, you don't need a starter hole. It'll just do it by itself. You know, those oscillating cutters, you just go in, and he's actually overcut, like here, for example. And it's like, well, why don't you just take the box, flip it over, put it against the wall, and then stencil around it, and then just cut inside the stencil? Well, he didn't do that. So anyway, all the boxes look like this. He's got these holes that are much bigger for no reason around the edges. If he would have taken a marker and just traced around the box itself, he wouldn't have had this issue. So that's the first thing I wanted to show you that's really, really horrible and, you know, is going to bite somebody in the ass because the side of that box, that screw that puts that little foot that pulls the box in, because he's not connecting to a stud. This is a new install, so he's actually cutting a hole in the facade and then putting this box in. Now, again, so every box you can see this. So there it is right there. You can see the hole right there. Again, not necessary if he would have traced it. And then here's another one right here. So it's actually on both sides. You can see that. Now, again, this client is very, very picky about this beautiful facade that they have. They really don't want, you know, more holes and they don't want any mistakes. Now, I'm doing the best I can to not make any mistakes. But so here's another thing that's kind of funny. So this guy originally, what he did was he actually tried doing a really nice job by putting these fasteners that hold this flex in place, this conduit, flexible conduit in place. So he's done it over here. He's screwed them down here, trying to do a nice job. This is kind of funny right here. He actually drills a hole right here, even though there's no back here. I don't understand why he did that. And he did it on all of these boxes. He drilled a hole to go into an open area and then left like a whole boatload of slack down there. So anyway, so why am I complaining about that? You know, he's got nice termination here on there on that end. So this was kind of funny. When he was testing this box, he did use a tester. He was using a ground tester. So what he did is he put the tester in the outlet, plugged it in, and it came up as, you know, whatever, showing that it was okay. And because this is a new outlet, it's pretty tough to pull out a plug. So what he does is he starts rocking it back and forth as he's pulling on it. And as he's rocking it this way, like this, it goes pop. And what do you think would happen? It's exactly what happened over there, is that those screws, he tightened it in too much, and then when he rocked it this way and then this way, he managed to have the hot touch the outer edge. And you know what? I'm going to take the screw off of this. Let's actually take a look. I'm going to pause you for a second. I'm going to take this plate off. Hold on. Okay, so I took the plate off of this side, and if you look right there, that might have been where it happened. But anyway, or maybe it was the ground wire back there that he put in there. I don't know. Anyway, oh, and the lines that you see on the screen, that's my headlamp. It just makes the camera go crazy like that. But anyway, so what happened was, as he was rocking it back and forth, I'm guessing that he shorted out the hot side to here, or there was the grounding wire that he's got tucked back there. You can just barely see it. And it probably just touched the edge of the wire, and you can actually see to mitigate it from popping again, he put electrical tape on both sides this time to stop it from touching. So that was the first thing that was kind of funny, is that as he's testing all of his outlets, he goes to test this one, and as he's removing the tester, it pops the circuit. Now, I was talking with the guy and I was like, well, this is probably the easiest install that you had. He was like, why do you say that? And I was like, well, I mean, all you had to do was go from this outlet up here, and you just went up and around the facade, and you just had to drill just a half a dozen holes, and that's all you had to do. Now, remember, this guy has been here since like 8 a.m., and he just left, and I think it's 5 p.m., so, you know, he's put in a full day of work, but in order to put in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 outlets, in the time that it took him to run 6 outlets, in the time that it took him to run 1 outlet, and I'll show you the outlet up there in just a minute, in the time it took him to run 1 outlet up in the balcony, and I'll show you how short of a run it was, I was able to run 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 14 XLR runs up, over, 6 down there, 4 down there, and then 5 over here, in the time which took me about an hour and a half, 2 hours, to pull that. Now I had to run them in pairs of 2, because I had these 2 boxes right here. So every run that I did, so like say for example here, this was 6 right here. This took 3 times to go up, over, and down, and then over here there was 4. So to go all the way from over there up, around, and then down, that took 2 tries, and then this one took another 2 tries because I had a white one that was just long enough, so I ran 3 at a time because that third one is going to go to the speaker right there. Anyway, so in that amount of time, I was able to run all those runs. So anyway, I said to the guy, I was like, you know, oh, this was probably a really easy install. And he was like, what do you mean? And I was like, well, you got to go, you know, just up, over, and down. And he was like, oh, no, this was really hard because, you know, this place has 270. And I'm thinking to myself, 270? What? You mean 240? 220? 220? You mean 220, right? No, 270. It's like I've never heard of 270 in my life. And so I'm coming over here, and now all 6 of those outlets which that he ran, everything comes back to this one outlet, which already had an outlet on it. And so basically, it took him over 8 hours to run what I just ran in less than 2 hours to go to there. Now, at a minimum, this whole system should be on at least 2 circuits, one on that side of the stage and then one on this side of the stage. But he's got everything common together and going to that one box there. Okay, all right, fine. So in my day, now I started at 10 o'clock because I don't like coming in stupid early for no reason. I don't mind going late. I just don't like coming in stupid early. So I came in at 10. So what I had to do was I had to drill through concrete here. And I'm going to go downstairs and I'll show you the rest. So hold on. So from where we were upstairs, I had to drill through all the concrete, and again, don't mind the noise. I had to drill through the concrete in the floor to come through there, up in that hole there. Drilled another hole through the concrete to come here. Now I haven't strapped any, I'm gonna strap this on the conduit. Now he did not run this conduit. This was actually from the fire system that actually goes up there. There's a laser beam or an infrared beam that shoots across the top of the sanctuary to tell if there's smoke or whatever. So this is actually for fire. He did not run this conduit. So I'm going to strap this to the conduit, so don't worry. But I had to drill that hole, which is, you know, over a foot thick. Drilled the hole. Came through there. Had to drill another hole right there. And again, I'm going to strap this to the conduit soon enough, which again is over a foot thick. Came through there, went through all the drop ceiling, and we'll go back over here. So I then had to go through this wall, which again is over a foot thick. Had to go from here through here. So I had to go through this wall here and then go into this wall. Actually, they might be under a foot thick. I think they might be 10 inches thick. 10 to 12 inches thick. Had to go through this wall, through this one, into here, into the ceiling here, and then I had to go into this access panel here. And this is not drop ceiling right here. You can't access it. You can't get in here. So what I had to do is I had to run a fishing rod from the hallway all the way through here. And there's a bunch of shit in the ceiling. There's electrical conduit. There's a big vent for this hood here. A whole bunch of shit in the way. It wasn't easy to get it all the way over here to this access panel. And then above this is a stairwell, which we're going to go to in a second. Okay, so we're coming into the stairwell here. So I had to go from that access panel in the basement. I had to drill through this, which is about 2 inches of concrete, 2.5 inches of concrete, and then it turns into steel. In another video, I explain how there's a steel piece of L bracket or angle steel, whatever, that actually holds up the concrete. And this is actually a piece of it that I drilled out. So, you know, about a quarter inch thick, quarter inch to 3/8 of an inch thick of steel, because it gets pretty thick on this one piece here. So I had to drill through the concrete and then through the steel to get up here to then go through more concrete in the ceiling here. I'll show you that here in a second. So we'll go in the back here. So I had to go through the concrete in here. I had to drill two different holes, one coming up, and then I made it bigger going down on an angle, because I like 1-inch holes to pull cable through, just in case, you know, I want to upgrade at some point. So anyway, to drill through all that concrete that I showed you took me probably, I want to say, from 10 a.m. when I started, and you don't start exactly at 10 a.m. So, you know, probably 30 minutes in, 40 minutes in. So anyway, from when I started, actually, I'm going to turn off this light and turn on this light. There we go. Okay. So from the time I started up until I'd say about 4 o'clock is when I finished drilling all those holes to get up to this point. Now, so going off of what I was saying, so to run all 14 of those lines on the stage over there, it took me about less than 2 hours. To run from this outlet right here, this is what the electrician was working on. So he tied in here. So he tied in here and ran to just over there. Took him about an hour and a half or 2 hours of what it took me to run 14 lines plus. So what he did was he put a quad box here. Okay. Now he had already put the quad box actually there. He just didn't put the outlets on it or the faceplate on it. So he had already drilled the hole before I had even came, and he had already ran the flex before I had already come. So it took him an hour and a half, no bullshit, an hour and a half, 2 hours, to put in two outlets in here to terminate it, and then to come over here and to tie it in to this pre-existing outlet right here. So it took him an hour and a half to 2 hours to do that, because I wasn't staring at my clock because I was busy pulling my cables. But here's where it gets really funny. So he puts he puts this extension on here just to make his life easier. But the funny thing was is that after he did all that and I finished pulling my cables, I heard him screwing in the last piece. And he's screwing it in, and then, and so he because he was working on it while it was live, he didn't want to turn it off. So what happened is that he had to go and he had to go find the breaker and reset the breaker, or he finished putting this on, had to go find the breaker, reset the breaker, and then test it, because he didn't want to do it live, or he didn't want to go find it and turn it off. So I'm just really disappointed, because he's already blown two fuses just putting in outlets. One because he had assembled it totally incorrectly, and then the other one because he didn't want to find the circuit panel to turn it off, and he didn't even bother strapping any of this stuff against the wall. You know, like, I mean, I get it for like low voltage stuff you don't have to worry about, but like, you know, with electrical, you know, live electrical, high voltage, you know, 120 volts and up, you want to strap the stuff down. So the last thing that I'm going to show you is over here. So he was trying to be a good guy by putting in, by strapping down the cable. And remember what I said before about how the client is very picky about facades and stuff like that, and the facade and not, you know, messing it up more than you need to. Well, again, at the top here, you'll notice on this side, he strapped it down like I showed you before. But on the underside, he made a bunch of uh-ohs. So there's one right there. Everybody will be able to see it when the lights turn on. So that's the screw holding the thing down on this side. And then there's an oops. 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 And there's an oops. So, and that one still actually has the screw showing. And it's like, dude, do you not realize that you need to screw on this side of the thing, not in the middle here? I mean, some people just are horrible with spatial awareness. So anyway, so let's go over here. So this is kind of funny to me. So what I'm assuming is he tried doing a good job on the other side. And then when he came over to this side, he didn't strap down anything. He just totally gave up on that idea. So everything is loose on this side coming off of the boxes. So probably he realized he made all the mistakes that he did. And he's like, well, I'm not doing that again. Because there's... Come on, focus. Wow. He only made the mistake one time right there. And then he's like, you know what? Screw it. I'm not going to do it anymore. So anyway, I don't know. I'm just really not impressed. Like, him just literally unplugging something right here blew the circuit. And then as he's reassembling that one up there, that took him over an hour and a half or 2 hours to tie in. Just to tie in. Took him an hour and a half. It took me the time to run 14 cables in the exact same location here. So anyway, just another electrician that I'm not impressed with. You know, my outlet, you know, I'll have to make a video showing of what my receptacles look like with everything terminated and everything like that, because you don't do that. You know, you gotta trace your holes before you cut it. And he had an oscillating tool. You know, those things, you don't have to pre-drill a hole. You don't have to make a pilot hole and then take like a jigsaw. You could just go straight in and you could make those lines razor tight, you know, like razor sharp, tight next to each other, you know. So anyway, I'm just overall not impressed. That's my rant for today on another junk electrician that just doesn't know how to do installation work. And I mean, the fact that he blew two circuits just really is, no, you know. So anyway, thanks for watching. I'll see you guys in the next one.